Hello and welcome to the channel. Here we have a rather tricky equation appeared to my best knowledge in 1954. A very remarkable year for me, so I just couldn't miss this task in my channel. Of course, all square roots here are so-called arithmetic square roots, defined for a non-negative real number, and the value of an arithmetic square root is also a non-negative real number. There is a minor technical issue here. The second square root is meant to be in line with others. This is not the power of 2, as someone may assume, but 2 times the square root. To solve the equation, I suggest building a sequence where the starting and the last elements are equal to each other. Then, if you can prove that all elements of the sequence must be equal to each other, the problem is practically solved. So please relax, put the video on pause, and try your best. Now let's solve together. We start with defining the domain, of course. Since we have 3x under the square root sign, x must be a non-negative real number. It can be easily seen that if x is non-negative, the expressions under all square roots are non-negative. This makes the values of all square roots defined. Therefore, the set of non-negative real numbers is the domain for the equation. It can be also noticed that if x is 0, then both sides of the equation are equal to 0. Therefore, x equals 0 is the solution of the equation. And we are looking for other solutions, assuming x to be positive. Next comes the previously mentioned sequence. Sequence S sub n, where n varies from 0 up to 1954. The sequence is defined recursively. The starting element S sub 0 equals x, while all the other elements are defined by a formula. S sub n equals square root of x plus 2 times S sub n minus 1. According to the property of an arithmetic square root, all elements of the sequence are non-negative. Moreover, it can be easily proven by induction that if x is positive, all elements of the sequence S are positive. However, that's not really important for the solution. The expression for S sub 1 can be found using the recursion formula. So S sub 1 equals square root of x plus 2 times S sub 0. And since S sub 0 equals x, we get square root of 3 times x for S sub 1. This is exactly the last square root in the left-hand side of the given equation. Let's see what we get for S sub 2. Again, we apply the recursion formula, substitute the expression for S sub 1, and the result is just the second last square root in the left-hand side of the given equation. And we continue the process, involving more and more parts of the equation into the expression for S. It can be easily seen that the index of S is the number of square roots involved in the formula for it. Therefore, the last element of the sequence, S with index 1954, will have 1954 roots, corresponding to the whole left-hand side of the given equation. And the left-hand side of the equation must be equal to x. So we get an equation S with index 1954 equals x, while at the same time x is the starting element of the sequence. So our sequence has the same element at start and at the end. And we desperately want to prove that all elements of the sequence are the same. This is your last chance to complete the solution on your own. Take the difference of 2 consecutive elements of the sequence, S sub n plus 1 minus S sub n. Applying the recursion formula to both terms, we get a difference of 2/3. Normally, we try to eliminate irrationality in the denominator. However, this time we, on the contrary, create an irrational denominator by means of multiplying and dividing the expression by its conjugate. This gives a fraction where the denominator is the conjugate, having plus instead of minus, while the numerator is the difference of two squares. In our case, we have square roots squared, which just leaves expressions under square roots. And of course, we can simplify the numerator by distributing and reducing the common terms. As the result, x's are cancelled out, and what remains is just twice the difference of two previous consecutive elements of the sequence. Note that since x is positive and elements of S sequence are at least non-negative, both thirds in the denominator are positive. Therefore, the whole denominator is positive. This means that the fraction is defined, and the sign of the fraction is the same as the sign of its numerator. So what we have actually come up with, the difference of any two consecutive elements has the same sign as the difference of two previous consecutive elements. Or if the difference of consecutive elements is zero, then the next difference of consecutive elements must be also zero. Applying this property step by step, we find out that if S sub 1 minus S sub 0 is positive, then any difference of two consecutive elements is positive. This means that S is a monotonically increasing sequence, so its starting element is strictly less than its last element. However, we want the elements to be equal. Therefore, the positive value of S sub 1 minus S sub 0 is out of consideration. In the similar way, if S sub 1 minus S sub 0 is negative, all the differences of two consecutive elements are negative, the sequence S is monotonically decreasing, and the starting element is strictly greater than the last element. This is also not what we are after. Therefore, the only case we can be pleased with is S sub 1 minus S sub 0 equals 0. So all the differences of two consecutive elements are 0, all the elements have same value, and the starting element is equal to the last element, just what we need. So the only thing remained is solving the equation S sub 1 minus S sub 0 equals 0. We have S sub 1 equals square root of 3 times x, while S sub 0 is just x. So this is the equation we need to solve, and we can solve it in mind. Just to avoid a possible confusion, let me divide both parts by square root of x, which is positive. That's what we get, and here is the value of x. However, we shouldn't forget x equals 0, which is also a solution. So our trick equation has two and only two roots. X sub 1 equals 0, x sub 2 equals 3. We have solved the equation and reached the end.